And there you are. Okay, so good afternoon, everybody. So I'm going to present one of the thematic logs. As already introduced by Simon, we already know about the European Marine Observation Data Network. What I'm going to show you is one of the thematic logs, that is physics. Physics is, I mean, we were asked to make available both near real-time and historical observation on physical parameters of the European ocean and global ocean. So what we are doing is, in a nutshell, we are putting together near real-time data, represented data, or archived data from the further elaboration, and we are dealing with the main physical parameters, so temperature, wind, salinity, atmospheric parameters, currents, optical properties. Recently, we were also asked to start working on underwater noise and river runoff. And on top of this data, we are also making available some products that could be trends or maps, as well as local fields or registry. I will show you later on some of the examples. And on top of all this data, what we are doing is also creating a partial level of services. So, we are, of course, we are making available this data via a GIS portal. We are making a catalog that has been used also by the central portal in order to integrate the data and make some of the products that we are offering available to other communities. But we are also creating some interoperability services, such as, thread servers, so WMS, WFS, and so on. And we also started working on RDAP and making available widgets. And again, I will show you some example of all these kind of services in a few slides. The main activity of physics is, physics is based on three main European pillars. So we are working in close collaboration with the operational people that are mainly grouped working together with the Copernicus infrastructure, and in particular with the in-situ TAC component of Copernicus. And of course, we are also working with the people that are more taking care about the historical validated dataset. So, the people from the National Oceanographic Data Centers and the CDataNet community. Together with this, these are the two main operational pillars of modern physics. And then we have also a third pillar, that is the Eurogos, which is more at strategic and coordination level. So, this community, that is you, together we are to work together in order to make available a common infrastructure to serve many users, as was presented by Simon. The final idea is to try to facilitate the data access and the use of and reuse of the data from many different users. For some specific parameters and platforms that are not yet managed by the different communities that I was mentioning, PhysX is starting creating the full data management flow. This is because we started an action with the HF radar that was later taken over by the Copernicus program, and we are now working on river outflow and underwater. Data origin. We are making available many data, and thanks to you that are sharing your data, modern physics is now capable to make available all these data. We have more than 2,500 moorings, more than 500,000 CTDs, more than 2,000 tie gauges, and so on. So we have one portal that is one of the components we recommend by the DG Mare, in order to make available thousands of data sets and many products and services. And at the moment, we have more than 25,000 connected platforms with providing more than 600,000 data sets. So, of course, we are working on this for many years. Some of you already know that. And we are trying to evolve the portal on a daily basis. So we are making available both, we try to match the user needs, so we try to make it as easy as possible. And the general idea was to make a portal that is a couple of clicks away from the data. So the user can find both, plots on the in situ observation as well as some products. In case of platforms, we are providing, presenting both the metadata about the providers, that is quite important to give words to you that are doing the job, because without the providers, of course, and modern physics and many other actions would not exist because we are not running any system. And on top of this data, we are making plots and discovering tools. And these are some of the products that we can create on top of these products. For example, this is the wind at sea level for the last 30 days. So you can see an animation in which you see the, these arrows that are moving and are, changing the size according to the direction and the strength of the wind. This is an example of the surface current field maps that we were able to make available on top of the HF radar. We are presenting the current field maps, but if the user clicks on one of the specific points, then he gets some further information about the specific components of the surface currents for that specific position. And this is an example of a different product that is a registry of the underwater impulsive noise. In this case, the main activity that we did was to harmonize the different registries that have been already created. In the north, especially in the Helcom and OSPAR region, they were quite advanced in this process, and ISIS is hosting their database. We started from that, and then we harmonized, we extended the ISIS grid down to the Mediterranean area, then we linked the data that have been started collecting by Acobans. At the moment, we are offering the first version of the European impulsive noise register. And this is quite important for the regional Sea Convention, as well as for the member state assessment related to the MSDF indicator 11.1. And this is another example of a product that we were able to make available thanks to the collaboration with the SeaDataNet community. In this case, we are showing, this is the surface climatology from the SeaDataNet system. And with this product, we were able also to offer the system to the services to the central catalog. And this product is now also available at the Atlas level. The feature that we implemented in physics is also to let the user to discover a bit more on this. So if you click on a position, then you get more information about the data in that specific point. So you get information about, the temperature, the average temperature for the different months, but you also get information about, the profile for that specific point in the different months. So you can, at least have a quick look about the data, and then in case you are interested in using this, you go back to the SeaDataNet and then you download the product and you make your analysis. But the title of the presentation was more related to, a tool for blue growth. When we are speaking about blue growth, as already presented by Simon, the idea is to have users that are using what we are developing. And now I'm going to present a couple of examples of some of the users that are using some of the services that we implemented. The first one is the Copernicus Institute ARC. This is because we are user and providers of each other. So it's nice to show this very fruitful collaboration. So while we are using their products in order to populate, the portal, the physics portal, in order to show the institute data, they're using our widget in order to make available some specific tools for their community. So we integrated each other with the services, and so we are serving two different communities. We are extending the communities that are using your data. Another example is from one company. This is an Italian company that is working on water pollutant inspection studies. And what they do is they harvest information they need, local information in order to run models about dispersion. And when they found out that modern physics is offering, sea surface currents fields, they were really eager to integrate this kind of real-time information into their model. Because in case of field, of course, having information, real-time information, running the models on top of very recent data can help in identifying, the roots of the fields and be more, react in a better way. Another example is from the German Aerospace Agency, who were
who are using, I mean, services created, an ad hoc service that we created for them in order to validate their satellite products. In particular, they were interested in validating some wind and wave products. So we make available an ad hoc FTP distribution server, and they're using on a daily basis this in order to validate their data. Another nice example is from EHI and HIMO Lab. They developed a database of the Mediterranean wind and wave model, and they used the data we exposed on physics in order to validate their database. Actually, they told me that they keep using because they run the model several times per year in order to update the system, and they are keep using our system. And in this case, they were selecting the data from the portal and downloading with the multi-selection feature that we expose. One last example is from the Lambda project
that has recently started working on River.
And the goal of this project, you're going to have a specific poster tomorrow, a presentation tomorrow on the activity. But the goal is to offer to the forecast community more information about rivers that are quite deeply affecting the coastal behavior. So thanks to what we have started doing in modeling physics, now more river data, runoff data is available, and so this kind of data can be integrated by means of easy tools for technicians, so API web services, into further application. So you can combine this data, you can assimilate this data into models in order to run new forecast. One last example is a different community. We are offering, the services for the map viewer of the Southern Ocean Observing System. In this case, it was very nice, the collaboration. It was a win-win collaboration because giving them a tool to make available and show their data, they were also helping us in order to make available more data in the system. And the final comment, the general comment of this is that we need to keep doing this kind of collaboration in order to avoid duplication efforts. And I see many presentations today in which we can take PISIS and put together in order to empower the services and provide better application and services to the end users. The last slide is, a sort of introduction of next presentation, but it's quite important to share data. So it's quite important this horizontal platform that has been created also at the modeling level that, I won't say anymore because Dick is going to present this, but please share your data. This is my final comment. And so we can create all the services on top of that.